What's up, guys? It's your girl, Stacey Cake, your host for What's Hot. Stop what you're doing. Make sure you subscribe to my channel right here. I'm here at the Pop Out Spring Pop-Up by my boy, Jay Stackhouse. Positive energy, positive vibes all the time. I'm going to be talking to some young black entrepreneurs and artists. You don't want to miss this, so stay tuned.
And now I'm just trying to spread love, be the greatest, pep B all across the nation. Run up a check till I'm tired of chasing. Now these niggas lazy watching the basement.
All right, so happy to be at another one of your events. You definitely rep for the fashion industry and the DMV. So just like as a young black entrepreneur, and you also just rapped here at the pop-up, showed us a little other side of you. You know, Nipsey Hussle's passing really touched a lot of artists, a lot of young black entrepreneurs, because he too had a fashion brand. He also was an artist mostly known for, you know, his raps and his storytelling lyrics and things like that. One thing when he passed, a lot of people were pointing out that he didn't get his due credit he deserved while he was here. As a rapper and as a somebody in the fashion industry, how can you relate to that, or can you relate to that at all?
I mean, definitely, you know, I want to speak on that first. Rest in peace, Nip. It was just crazy, man, to see what happened. And, you know, I can't really understand people saying a lot about, you know, he should have got more credit while he was here. A lot of people knew who he was and what he was about. And that's why it's so much of an outpouring of love, you know. I think people can always show a little bit more support. It's a lot of hate and a lot of jealousy in the world just because somebody might see somebody not doing what they're doing yet or something on their level. But, I mean, I really think we should just all come together and support each other a lot more, like, especially while we are here. Like, show love. Don't be afraid to show love. If it's somebody that you look up to or you want to do what they're doing, reach out. Reach out and talk to them, ask for advice and things like that.
So personally, I go through this experience on a regular day-to-day basis. So I get more support from Instagram followers that I don't know than like support from the people that I do know. People are like, oh, I'm going to get something. I'm going to get this. I'm going to support you. And a simple post, you don't even have to buy nothing from me. A simple repost of my business or my brand would just make me satisfied. So people don't genuinely, and some people envy your success. The closest people envy your success. So you got to watch out from the people who you call your friends if they really aren't your friends.
Like when you hit from a place, it's hard to get people to recognize you, you know, because a lot of people is out, it's all about clout, who you know, what are you to the hood or whatever the case may be. And there's a lot of people that don't like you because they see that you doing something and they want to be either in a position you are or in a higher position than you are. So I feel like it's like that everywhere.
Yes, Matt. I feel like people support you way more when you pass away. It's just like they just want to memorialize you. They want to represent you. But it shouldn't be like that. We got to represent people while we're here. We got to support black businesses right now. Right now.
Okay. And since this is a fashion event, you know, we see a lot of young black entrepreneurs. You're an active part of Positive Energy, Positive Vibes, the Pep V brand. So as like somebody also a part of the fashion industry, Fashion Nova, I'm sure it's a brand you see frequently. Fashion Nova has been accused of stealing designs from young black entrepreneurs like yourself. Do you feel like that's just the name of the game in fashion, or do you think it's problematic?
Well, I really believe everybody like takes from one another, but it's how you do it. If you're taking something that's not noticeable and spin it into your own, that's fine. It's when people blatantly steal from people who can't do nothing to them. That's just bullying. That's what these bigger companies want to do to us. They want to bully us and thinking they the only ones who had the power to do something like that. Yes, man. When we can make it big. If we support each other, we can make it big.
Stop stealing the drip. Stop stealing the drip. Come up with your own ideas.
Yes.
And the term drip, it don't gotta be something expensive for you to drip. Look at me. Drip.
You dig?
Stop stealing the drip. But it's not fair. Like, get your own shit. I don't think it's right. I think they steal it. And people don't get credit for that. And that's wrong.
I feel like I got mixed feelings about it. It's, but it's, it's a fair game because it's like, all right, if you don't want nobody stealing your stuff, copyrighting, but even still, people can still take what you made and switch it around to be a little bit more different. So, I mean, it's a fair game. I mean, it's life.
It's definitely unfortunate, but at the same time, when it comes down to the fashion game, that's like what it's always been. You know what I'm saying? Whenever, like, you know, a big brand releases a certain type of collection, or like even like, you know, like the Tiffany Blue, you know what I'm saying? When Tiffany Blue hit the scene, everybody wanted to go with that same type of indigo tone for a minute. When LeBron James had the South Beaches, you know what I'm saying? Now all the shoe like brands coming out with South Beach colorways and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So that's always been in fashion, you know what I'm saying? Do I think it's fair? No, but you know, it's the industry that you're working in, you know what I'm saying? It's not about who did it first, it's about who did it right, you know what I'm saying? So if you do fall victim to this, I mean, I wouldn't say don't let it, like, don't focus on it. Don't let it take you down as in, oh, shit, they took my design. I can't do this no more. No, just keep on upping yourself up.
I do think fashion, I think it's fair game. I think fashion repeats itself. I think you go from the high end to the low end. As a young black entrepreneur myself, I just going to stay focused, stay consistent, and I know things will work out, but kind of fair game to me, I think it is.
So just to play devil's advocate a little bit, because y'all are very adamant in your position, I think possibly a lot of the outrage is coming because Fashion Nova is such a big brand and it's stealing from smaller brands. And that's why a lot of people see it as problematic. But let me pose this opposition. So think about Rihanna's brand, Fenty. You remember the first lies? Every girl had them and wanted them in every color. Now, smaller brands got a hold of that design, and you started seeing them in the malls and in the local stores. And those same fans who maybe couldn't afford the Fenty started purchasing the replicas, the dupes, from smaller designers. Is that still problematic?
Stop stealing the drip. You got to stop stealing the drip. That's all.